everybody. Jimmy with Do the Top Crane here. Today we're going to play with more rail cars. So we have, I think, three rail cars that we either need to offload or put on a set of wheels. I'm not sure what's going on. I was just told three cars, 65,000 pounds. Go out there and do it. So that's what we're going to do. So we got set up on this first rail car. We've got three of them to do, but I don't know that my batteries are going to hold out for all three of them. I've got three cameras running. So I've got my Hero 5 session right above my head, hopefully where you guys can see the controls. I've got the Osmo Pocket pointing out the front windshield. And I've got my Hero 5 up on the Beckett pointing straight down. So hopefully we'll get some pretty good footage. I'm going to be pretty near capacity on picking this. So it's going to beep at us, I'm sure. Kyle's getting me centered up on it, and then we'll go with it. You like it? All right, here we go. We've got our 25-foot oranges on, which are good for 50,000 a piece in a straight line. This rigging angle, they're going to be good for about 35,000 a piece. And then we've got our foundry hooks on the bottom. 2.5-inch shackle up top in the hook with the four straps in it. And I'm going to quit talking because I got to run a crane. So right there, we got about 22,000 on it. fat head out from in front of that camera up above me. Before I come clear off of it, you want to hook up to it with something, or as long as you got the wheels talked and it's not going to roll into me, we're good. Good. All right, there's the first of three. Coming down a little bit, get rid of my deflection. You like it? Okay, well, there's the first one. Let's see if we have enough battery to do the other, or record the other two. Getting lined up on it right now, and then we'll go with it. stuff outside. It's pretty noisy. Alright, we're at a 48.7 foot radius. We're good for 55,000 right here. So I'm anticipating a beeping. Should just be pre-alarm. It would be a constant, steady beep. Just a beep, 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 instead of the pause in between them. So that was just pre-alarm, letting us know we're getting close. like it? Got chocks under it. Cut it loose and move to the next one. Alright, this is our third and final one. This time I've got my Hero 5 on the block instead of on the end of the boom. See what that view looks like on this deal. The battery's almost dead in it, so it may not even make it through the whole pick. We'll see. Kyle's getting me lined up on it. Said it looks good. So we'll go ahead and start putting some tension on it. So far, I think the Hero 5 session above my head is still hanging in there. I'm just going to let it record until it goes dead. So you guys may get part of our teardown. All that good stuff too, so we'll see. Alright, we're starting to gain some weight. We're at 9,000. We're going to keep an eye on our radius. I want to let it drift away from me just a little bit. So I've only got about 2.5, maybe 3 feet between my outrigger and the steering knuckle on this car, so if it goes anywhere, I want it to go away from me. All right, we got almost 30,000 on it. I'm gonna try to hold that radius. That's, I let it drift out about a foot from where Kyle spotted me. Now I'm just booming up. 41,000, 42,000. Giving a little cable up. 46,000. 49,000. My GoPro. You guys will find it in a minute. So my Hero 5 just fell off the block. Hey, as long as the SD card survived, it'll be good. The cover or the magnet mount? Well, they still build them. It's the cost of doing business. that GoPro fell from about 40 feet into the bottom of a rail car. So, see how that works out. Well, he found the camera. The mount's probably still in the car. It's got magnets on it. Did the camera survive?
It's still recording.
It's still recording?
I didn't turn it off.
That's funny. No kidding.
Not cracked or nothing?
No, not cracked at all. That surprises me. I wrote that thing off. It's just dirty. That's funny. That's gonna be some cool footage.
Yeah.
Yeah, the mount's probably still inside the car.
They gotta cut that side adjuster off.
Oh, okay. I'll just sit here and hold it. Yeah, just got dirty. Put a little ding in it. Pretty tough little fella. I really figured it was trash.
I didn't know it failed.
Yeah, when that one of the foundry hooks tore through the side of the car a little bit, and then it caught and it jerked everything just a little bit, and that's when it popped off there. I should have tied it on there with some string, but I didn't figure if it fell, it wasn't gonna hit anybody, so I wasn't overly worried about it. But
right.
Honestly, there's a part of me that wishes that it was broken, because then I would have had to buy a Hero 7 or a Hero 8. But I guess I won't be doing that now. What's that? Getting some colorful language outside the crane. Guess I'll turn the cameras off.